Evaluate integral 0 to pi d theta upon a plus b cos theta where a greater than modulus b. We wish to transform this given integral to the type integral 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta sin theta d theta where f of cos theta sin theta is a rational function on sin theta and cos theta. Since we have a relation integral 0 to 2 a f of x dx equals 2 times integral 0 to a f of x dx whenever f of 2a minus x equals f of x, and since we have cos theta equals cos of 2 pi minus theta, we have integral 0 to 2 pi d theta upon a plus b cos theta equals 2 times integral 0 to pi d theta upon a plus b cos theta. Hence, the given integral 0 to pi d theta upon a plus b cos theta can now be written as 1 by 2 times integral 0 to 2 pi d theta upon a plus b cos theta. Now, we have obtained the integral of the form integral 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta sin theta d theta. Thus, we can depend on the substitution z equals e raised to I theta so that we can make use of the relations d theta equals dz upon iz and cos theta equals 1 by 2 times z plus 1 by z. Thus, we have this integral rewritten in this form. You take LCM in the denominator and you get this simplified form. In the denominator, you have bz square plus 2az plus b, which is a quadratic expression in z, and you will find out the roots of this quadratic equation in order to find out the poles. We have z equals minus 2a plus minus, z equals minus 2a plus minus root of 4a square minus 4b square upon 2b. After cancelling 2 from both numerator and denominator, we have z equals minus a plus minus root of a square minus b square upon b. If z1 equals minus a plus root of a square minus b square upon b, when you evaluate modulus, you have modulus z1 is less than 1. This is because since a greater than modulus b is given in question, we have a by b is greater than 1. From where we have negative a by b is less than 1. Here, when you evaluate modulus z1, you have negative a by b to which you add root of a by b the whole square minus 1. So this expression will surely be less than 1. Thus, z1 is a pole which lies inside the unit circle. Now we will evaluate modulus z2. We have a by b is greater than 1 and hence modulus z2, which is obtained as a by b plus root of a by b the whole square minus 1, will surely be greater than 1. Since modulus z2 is greater than 1, we have z2 is a pole which lies outside the unit circle. Therefore, it is enough to evaluate residue of f of z at z equals z1, which is a simple pole. We have limit z tends to z1, z minus z1 into f of z obtained as limit z tends to z1 2 by ib into z minus z2. By direct application of limits, we have 2 by ib into z1 minus z2 obtained as this value. B and b can be cancelled. Also, negative a and a gets cancelled. In the denominator, we obtain 2 times root of a square minus b square. 2 and 2 gets cancelled and we have residue of f of z at z equals z1 obtained as 1 by I into root of a square minus b square. By residue theorem, we have integral over c f of z dz obtained as 2 pi I into sum of residues. That is 2 pi I divided by I into root of a square minus b square. Thus, we have the required value obtained as 2 pi divided by root of a square minus b square. We are asked to find out the value of integral 0 to pi d theta upon a plus b cos theta. Now we have evaluated value for integral 0 to 2 pi d theta upon a plus b cos theta, which was equal to integral over c f of z dz, where f of z is this expression. So now we have to multiply 1 by 2 to the answer that we have obtained. Therefore, the given integral will have the value 1 by 2 multiplied to 2 pi upon root of a square minus b square. So the final answer will be pi by root of a square minus b square.